Have you ever wondered why, despite all the fat-free foods, weight loss programs, and gym memberships, so many of us seem to be getting fatter? Every day, everywhere, we're bombarded with countless numbers of ads and articles all telling us how to lose fat. But did you know our bodies already know how? As we eat, our body converts our food into glucose, a simple sugar that travels through our bloodstream. This glucose is the primary food for our cells. Whether it's a muscle cell or a brain cell or a cell in our heart, they all feed on glucose. As glucose moves through our bloodstream, our pancreas produces a hormone called insulin. Insulin is the gatekeeper of our cells. It opens the door, allowing glucose to enter and be used for our energy needs. Without it, our cells can't be fed. What if we eat more than we need? Well, along with our brain cells and muscle cells, we also have fat cells. Our cells never eat more than they need, so when we have more glucose than our cells can use, the excess amount is stored in our fat cells where it is converted into free fatty acids. Once the glucose is out of the bloodstream, with our cells having been fed and the surplus having been stored away in our fat cells, then insulin closes the doors to our cells and slowly leaves our body. When our body needs more energy, or glucose, and we don't have any food handy, it turns to the fat cells and the free fatty acids stored inside them. The free fatty acids leave our fat cells and go right back into the bloodstream to feed all our other cells. They don't need insulin to open the cell doors. That's why they're referred to as free fatty acids. This natural process of storing fat when you have too much glucose and burning fat when you don't have enough glucose is how your body was designed to work. And in a perfect world, eating a perfect diet, everything works perfectly. Unfortunately, we don't live in a perfect world. And most of us don't even come close to eating a perfect diet. As a result, we don't benefit from this natural process very often. Instead, we suffer by storing too much fat and rarely, if ever, burning any. Let's take a look at a typical breakfast in our imperfect world. When we get up in the morning, the first thing most of us have is a breakfast fairly high in sugar and processed foods. When this kind of food enters our body, it's converted into glucose very quickly and rushes into the bloodstream. The more sugary the food, the faster and higher our blood sugar or glucose level rises. Our pancreas senses this sudden spike in glucose and responds by pumping out the insulin, creating an insulin spike to correspond to the fast-rising glucose. The insulin does its job and opens the doors to our cells. All our working cells are fed, and all the excess glucose is then stored in our fat cells. Now, this process happens fast. Once insulin arrives, the glucose level in our bloodstream goes back down pretty quickly. However, it takes much longer for insulin to leave our body. So even though the glucose level in our bloodstream comes down fairly quickly, our insulin level remains high. And this can be a significant problem because as long as there is insulin still in our body, we can't access the free fatty acids stored in our fat cells. Remember, free fatty acids don't need insulin to allow them into the cells, but they do need insulin to be gone before they can leave our fat cells. Our body needs to eat continually. Free fatty acids can't leave the fat cells. On come the cravings, the irritability, and so we eat. Our glucose levels spike right back up. Our body releases even more insulin. The doors open. The cells are once again fed. And excess glucose is put into our fat cells. With our insulin level remaining high, we're still not able to release any fatty acids. So we continue adding to the fat storage, but never taking any out. This cycle continues through lunch, mid-afternoon snacks, dinner, and so on. We literally end up bathing our bodies in insulin all day long and for much of the night. After a while, all that insulin takes a toll. We age much faster than normal, and many of us develop type 2 diabetes. There is a way to break this cycle, a simple, natural way to restore our body's natural fat-burning process. Instead of the spike in glucose and insulin we typically experience, drinking BioSlive Slim before or during a meal allows for a more mild release of these two elements. This milder release allows the insulin levels to mirror glucose levels, and therefore burn out at about the same time as the glucose. When these two levels drop together, our fat cells are now able to release the free fatty acids, and we enter what we call the fat burning zone, the period of time in which our body burns off excess fat. No more cravings, and no more feeling tired. After a couple of hours in the fat-burning zone, we're ready to have BioSlive Slim with our next meal, and we start the cycle again, storing less fat, and burning more of what was already stored. If you're in a hurry to lose that excess fat and want to accelerate your success with BIOS Life Slim, we suggest 5 simple adjustments you can start today. Number 1. Eat a high-protein breakfast each morning. You'll love our delicious Lean Complete Meal Replacement Shake, and it meets the criteria of a high-protein, low-carbohydrate breakfast. Number 2. Along with BIOS Life Slim, eat 3 healthy, well-balanced meals that include lean protein, healthy fats, and complex carbohydrates. Number 3. Space your meals appropriately. Allow at least 4 hours between breakfast and lunch, 4 hours between lunch and dinner, and 12 hours between dinner and breakfast, allowing your body to burn fat even while you sleep. Number 4. Increase your physical activity. You don't need to become an exercise fanatic. Just find opportunities to do a little more each day. Number 5. Decrease the amount of sweets and processed foods you eat. Especially avoid soft drinks and so-called sports drinks, which can be full of sugar and cause a huge release of insulin. BIOS Life Slim, the natural way to turn your body from a fat-storing machine into a fat-burning machine.